truth is you don't really need to go out and approach women on the street to get women. Although that can be fun to do if you enjoy it. Because as you get better and better at being connected, listening, talking, women will just show up in your life. You'll run into them, friends will introduce you, you'll go to parties. If you believe women are gonna be in your life, they will show up in your life. And you'll be surprised. You'll be like, oh my God, I spent so many years having trouble getting a date, now I've got more dates, I know what to do with it, I don't even really approach anymore. That's why I don't look at approaching as the way to get women, I look at it as a great tool to weed all your insecurities. And so there's all kinds of training drills we have for that to weed out the insecurities. Because as they go away, you'll bump into somebody and start to have a conversation. I always remember when this first happened to me, many years ago, like 10 years ago, and I'd always worked really hard to get a date, and I would always go out and do all this approaching stuff, and work. And then one day, I think I ended up with, I bumped into one girl who was introduced through somebody else, got a date with her, down at Venice Beach in California. My dog started playing with another girl's dog, I got a date from her, and I just realized dates were just happening. Suddenly I looked back and I said over that week and I said, oh, these girls are just showing up in my life. I'm not really doing anything to go meet them. I'm doing my everyday life and I'm just meeting women. This is interesting. This didn't used to be like this. And that's when I realized something shifted inside of me. Now, that doesn't mean you don't actively, like, if I want to meet women that are of a certain type that maybe are really into art, yeah, go to art galleries. Maybe I'm heavy into fitness and I want to date women that are into fitness because I think that would be a good match. Yeah, go do that. But do you see the point? Make yourself naturally magnetic. You're built to attract women, guys. You're male. Men are built to attract women. Women are built to attract men. So if you're not attracting women, what is it that you're doing to keep them at bay? That's the question. And that's always the case. There's something in your nervous system that got the message that women are dangerous, that women are bad, then I need to keep them at bay. So I need to do, and you're gonna see it this weekend firsthand, I need to do a bunch of funky stuff to push them away. And you're gonna see, you're gonna stand in front of one of these ladies, you're gonna look at them, your head's gonna do like weird stuff. It's gonna pop back, your lip's gonna shake, you're gonna pull your head this way, hey, how you doing? And you're like, what's up, hi. And you've been talking from here, and the girls will be like, what the fuck? Yeah, on the surface, you are being nice, but all your energy is saying, stay away from me. And they're gonna feel that, and you're gonna all see that on every guy that comes up here. Some of you will be better than others, some of you will have more quirks than others. But as you see that how much subtle communication plays, because like, we talk about tension, right? So as I look at her, am I avoiding the tension of the emotional connection? And we all do it, right? Am I like looking in, enjoying, relaxing, or am I like, hey, pulling back? And what I'm literally doing is avoiding that emotional vulnerability, which is a form of tension. And I'm saying, like, keep that, I don't want too much of that, I don't want too much of that. And when women connect through emotions and you take all the emotions away, what happens? Well, they don't want to talk to you. Yeah. Why would they want to talk to you? Their whole land is like, let's have some emotion together, some feeling, some tension, something, and you give them nothing, they're gonna run away. Or they're gonna walk away, they're just gonna not be interested. Okay, so good. We got one more?
Sorry, yeah, no, you just, when you say there that women would kind of have to bring up your insecurities, in other words, then it's not really about us meeting girls. It's what we experience when we're in front of them.
Mm-hmm.
It's obviously about inner work. It brings up something inside you that you actually need to deal with yourself.
Yeah. If you really believed, and I don't mean believe like I choose to believe. I mean belief at a deeper level. One of my mentors said this years ago, and it's super true, that when people used to use the word belief way back in the day, meant that they were actually living it. Okay. That wasn't like today we say, I believe that, but you're not living it, so you don't believe it. If you're living it, you believe it. It's part of your subconscious, right? So if you really believed you were good with women, women would be in your life. It's not, and it doesn't matter if you're short, bald, fat, ugly, it would just happen. They would start showing up. And so there's something internally that's holding them at bay, that's causing all your subcommunication to tell them to stay away. And that's what I want you guys to see clearly. How much your subtle communication plays into pulling them in and pushing them away all day long. Why? Because they're so emotionally adept at feeling the subtlest emotion. And it just, and they're very loyal to emotion feeling, women, if they're feminine. You know, there are masculine women, of course, and there's feminine men, but I'm talking about in general.
I'm really physical, so I have issues with like, people tell me to do something with my body.
Uh-huh.
I'm like, the hell do you mean? If I can't see it, if I can't feel it with my own body.
So you're tactile, really, kinesthetic, tactile.
Right, yeah. Okay. So I noticed, I just noticed that I have so many borders, barriers inside that don't permit me to open up and to ground myself while in communication.
Yeah, I get that. I'd be interested to see you in front of a girl, because I think you're looking at your body, the way the energy runs, you're very capable of it. You understand what feeling is. I can see that on you already. The question is under tension, do you do it? You know, how much are you comfortable with courage? So I want to invite you guys into full participation this weekend, but keep an open mind, you know. I might say something that contradicts something else you've heard. I might say something that contradicts myself in a way. So if that happens, ask me why I'm contradicting myself. Because contradictions are very common in doing internal work. We're filled with contradictions. And so depending on the relative direction I'm looking at it at that moment, I'll say it in different ways. And I'll say it differently to two different people. I might say one thing to you and one thing to you that seems like a contradiction, but in reality, if you ask me, I'll show you how it's not. I'll give you one example of that, and this is why I want you to keep an open mind. I had a mentor that hated quantum leaps, and he says they don't exist, they're bullshit. And he said, I've spent years studying personal growth and teaching people to become millionaires. He's a millionaire himself, and he was known as the millionaire maker. And he said, quantum leaps don't exist. It's all compounding interest. If you learn to do little tiny things every day, the compounding will take you to success. And he wrote a whole book on it, super successful. It's a phenomenal book called The Slight Edge by Jeff Olson. I highly recommend you read it. Everybody I give it to says they put in like their top five books for really learning to be a success. But then I had another mentor, David Nagel. And David said the opposite. He said, I believe in the quantum leap. You learn from Bob Proctor, if you know who Bob Proctor is. And he said, the quantum leap is like, you can change your life overnight. He says, I was challenged by Bob Proctor to go from 60,000 a year to 60,000 a month in my income. And I did it and I've never looked back. It took me 3 months to do it actually. And he said, 2 or 3 months. He said, but when I did it, I've never made less than that. And he says, I had a huge quantum leap overnight. And I had to look at both those and say, well, now they're contradicting each other, right? And they're both great teachers and they both believe what they're saying. And Jeff Olson would say that everybody that says that's just doing it for marketing.